Today in this beautiful morning, we are in Orlando, Florida at Architectural Aluminum Techniques, which is a glazing contractor. The unitized glazing system, which we're going to see some of today, is performed here using all of Tremco's products.
It actually starts a little bit even before it gets to the shop floor, and that's on the drafting and engineering department. And then once the drawings are approved, we further detail each frame, working in a sequential manner, almost like a Lego set, working from left to right or right to left.
We receive our stock lengths of material. We cut and mill and drill those stock lengths to the desired sizes.
And then from there it goes to assembly, where they're assembled, and of course that's where the Tremco sealants come in. All the Tremco sealants are used in the joinery of where the frames are, horizontal, verticals are meeting together. And then at the same time, after the assembly, the gaskets are applied, and those are those Tremco gaskets that we have.
It's assembled. We have a QC process that we use along the way to ensure that each step is documented.
And then once the frame is assembled, it rolls on over to the glazing area where the glass is laid on top of the gasket. And after that's laid in place, the final step is to apply a continuous perimeter structural silicone. We're using the ProGlaze 2 part. And once that's done, at the horizontal locations, we also have another weather seal that's usually on the face of the glass, where the face of the glass meets the adjoining face of the glass. So that's applied as well, with some backer rod first and then sealant. And that's again tooled in for a nice smooth finish, because that's now exposed, of course. And once that's done, any other gaskets that are required for sealing one panel to the other, or sealing the top and bottom of the frame to the adjacent substrate, is slid in place as well. There's also some Tremco gasket that are called wedge gaskets that are put in place in addition to the weather seals.
After that, once it's trimmed out, what we do is we put in what we call a bunk, which is just a wooden rack which we laid the frames flat in for transportation and for storage on site until an opening is ready.
And then picked up from the bunk with the use of a crane typically, and yep, and lifted up in place, and then they're secured to the building. The last step after all that's done is, again, quite often we're using Tremco sealant, where we apply a perimeter seal from our frame to the adjacent substrate on the side, and head and seal at the bottom.
Okay.
So that's the final step.
The benefits you gain with in-plant or unitized glazing is the speed in which you can install. You take out a lot of the weather problems and delays that can happen on the job, from typical stick building, which would be installing a frame, setting the glass, pushing in the gasket, or pumping the silicone, whichever the case may be. The unitizing does all that for you in a controlled environment. So once you ship it to the site, it's literally just hanging panels that have been prefabricated, pre-glazed, siliconed in place, gasketed. So it enables to speed up the schedule, which is saving everybody money.